topic in mathematics, that is geometry. Okay, so geometry is a very important topic. So here, like in real life situations, any figure, any closed shape you see, that is all based on geometry. Okay, so here where we can connect mathematics with real life objects. Now, what is actually the basic thing which we are going to learn in this class? We are going to learn about two-dimensional flat shapes as well as three-dimensional solid shapes. So first let us cover up the flat shapes. So let us first move to the definition. Shapes which can be drawn on a sheet of paper or a plane surface, that is called a flat shape. Okay, now they are closed shapes. Why they are closed shapes? Because the end points of the shapes, they meet or they are connected. So they are made up of they can be made up of line segments, or they can also be made out of curves. Line segments or curves, both are used to make the closed shapes. Okay, so let us take an example of a closed shape. The best example is this. You see, I have started with one point. I am turning round and round, and again this will meet in the same point. So what is this shape? This shape is called as circle. So this is the first closed shape, which is made out of curve. Now the next shape, you see, I have started from this point. I have extended a straight line like this. Turned. It has turned now. Now again. And now again it is connecting with the point where it is started. So what is this shape called? This shape is looking like a, just a moment children. This shape is looking like a rectangle. Another important shape, in this shape if you see, it is started from here. Another important shape is, this is a three-sided figure. This shape is triangle. So these are the examples of the flat shapes, the basic flat shapes which you are going to read in this chapter. Now students, let us learn about solid shapes. What are solid shapes? Let us first understand the definition. Solid shape is a three-dimensional shape. What do you mean by three-dimensional shape? Three-dimensional shape means the shape will have all the three things, that is length, width and height. Now look at this particular shape. It is a cube. Okay. Just I don't have a cube with me right now, but I can show you a cuboid. This looks like a cuboid. You can see this particular cuboid, you know, it has got a length, it has got a width, and it has got a height also. If I keep it and show it in this way, it has a height also. Yes or no? So it is showing you three dimensions. Now if I will talk about some solid shapes. This solid shape is made up of completely straight lines. Yes or no? This solid shape which I showed you just now, this shape, it is made up of straight lines. But there are many other solid shapes which are not necessarily made up of straight lines. Like for example, look at this solid shape. This is what? It is a sphere. It is a sphere, a ball. So it looks like a sphere to you. Now this sphere, you know, it is not made up of straight lines, but it is made up of curved. It made up of curved lines. So you can see, I have made a sphere. So these kind of curved lines you can make in a sphere very easily. So it is also three-dimensional shape because you can hold it in your hand and it occupies a space. Yes or no? You can hold this circle which you draw it on a board. Okay, if I will draw a circle on the board in this way, can I hold this circle? See, unless and until you make a paper cutting, you cannot, you will see that there is no thickness in it. But if you see a sphere, you have a thickness in it. Understood? So this is also a three-dimensional object. Now there are other three-dimensional objects. Look at this shape. What do you call? What do you call to this shape? It is something you have a rounded base like this. You can see this, it is circular, na? It is round here. Okay, now and slowly this is pointing. It is going to a point in the top. So this point is called as the vertex of the cone and this circle is called as the base of the cone. So this is also a three-dimensional shape because it has got all the three things, that is, it has got a length, width and height. Another three-dimensional object can be this bottle. This bottle is not exactly cylinder, but it looks somewhat like cylinder only. Okay, here you have a circular base in the top, a circular base in the down. Okay, and this is a curved surface in the middle. So this is a three-dimensional shape. So different three-dimensional shapes which we have seen. So cube, cuboid, cone, cylinder, sphere. Okay. Now the next thing that we are going to learn is about lines. Okay, any shape you make that is made out of lines. So what are the different types of lines we use for making shape? You can use sleeping line like this. This is a sleeping line. Or we also call it as horizontal line.
Now students, let us go through the questions from warm-up exercise. Here we have question number 1. How many of each do you see in the given picture? So this picture, you see some lines are there to make this picture. We have standing lines, sleeping lines, slanting lines, curved lines. We have to count how many of each we are seeing in this picture. So first we are doing for standing lines. Standing lines means vertical lines. Okay. 1 here, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. Okay, so total 4 vertical standing lines are here. Next is sleeping line. Sleeping lines means horizontal lines like this. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3 here, and this part, this is also a part of this whole. Okay, so we can keep 3 only. 1, 2, 3. 3 sleeping lines are there. Next we come to slanting lines. Slanting lines, you can see this is 1, 1, this is 2, and this is 3, and this is 4. Next we come to curved lines. We have 2 curved lines, you can see here. These are the, okay. Now we come to the next question. Match the following solid shapes with their names. So which of them looks like a cube here? You can see this shape looks like a cube. Cylinder, this shape looks like a cylinder. Sphere, this shape looks like a sphere. Next comes to cone. So this figure looks like a cone in this way. Okay, so please do it in the book in this way. Complete all the questions. Okay, thank you. Bye.